Good morning students, welcome you to 10th standard English class. So far we have completed 5 units, prose, poetry and supplementary lessons. In today's video we are going to see unit 6, prose. Title of the lesson is The Last Lesson, written by Alphonse Daudet. First we'll see about the author. Alphonse Daudet. His period is from 1840 to 1897. He was a French novelist and a short story writer. The Last Lesson is set in the days of the Franco-Prussian War, that is from 1870 and 1871, in which France was defeated by Prussia, led by Bismarck. Prussia then consisted of what now are the nations of Germany, Poland and parts of Austria. In this story, the French district of Alsace and Lorraine have passed into Prussian hands. So here he tells about this author, Alphonse Daudet. He is a very famous French novelist, and in this story we are going to see how the narrator is going to tell about the importance of French language. We'll see the introduction part of this story. This lesson is set in the days of France-Prussian War. France was ruled by Bismarck. Prussian then consisted of what now are the nations of Germany, Poland and parts of Austria. The Prussians defeated the French and the district of Alsace and Lorraine fell into the hands of the Prussians. The oppressors not only wanted the territory but dominated over the language and culture of the Germans, thus to take away their identity. Read the lesson to find out what impact this had on life at school. So here in this story we are going to see how it affected the language and how the culture of German, they are going to thus to take away their identity. So in this story we are going to see the importance of French, and here the narrator France is going to tell about his experience. We'll see the characters. The narrator of the story, a little boy named Franz, and his teacher Mr. Hamel, who is a French master. Next we'll see the gist of the lesson. Here Franz, the schoolboy, also the narrator of this story, dreaded to go to school that day because his teacher would question him about the rules of the participles, that is grammar part. When he reached the school, he could see the unusual scene at school. There was a strange atmosphere. He saw some villagers were sitting in the class. Everybody looked sad. Franz wondered what was happening that day. Franz was very sorry when he heard it was his last French lesson. Mr. Hamel, the French master, was gazing at many things. As the church clock struck 12, everyone heard the trumpets of the Prussian soldiers returning from their drill. Mr. Hamel could not continue his talk. He then made a sign with his hand that school is dismissed. The students, along with the village elders, felt bad for not showing interest in learning French and wasting their time in unwanted things. So, in this lesson, we'll see the lesson in detail in the remaining part. Now we'll see the lesson in detail. First paragraph. I started for school very late that morning and was in great dread of a scolding, especially because Mr. Hamel had said that he would question us on participles and I did not know the first word about them. For a moment I thought of running away and spending the day out of doors. It was so warm, so bright, the birds were chirping at the edge of the woods, and in the open field back of the sawmill, the Prussian soldiers were drilling. It was all much more tempting. So here, we'll see the meaning first. Dread means fear, and the next one is chirping. Chirping means sharp sound made by birds and insects. And the next one, woods. Here woods refers to the forest. So here the first paragraph, first word I refers to the boy Franz. So here the narrator of the story is a little boy named Franz rushed to school one morning. He was anxious about his teacher, Mr. Hamel, who would question him on participles. Here, participles refer to the grammar part. The narrator had not learned the lesson. So, he started for his school very late that particular morning. He was in great dread of getting scolding from his French master, Mr. Hamel. Franz wanted to skip that day's classes as Mr. Hamel informed them about a test on participles, that is grammar part. The outside natural scenery of a warm sun, chirping birds at the edge of the forest, with Prussian soldiers practicing their drill in the open fields were more tempting to Franz rather than the rules for participles. But Franz resisted this and urged and hurried off to school. Then the rule for participles, but I had the strength to resist and hurried off to school. When I passed the town hall, there was a crowd in front of the bulletin board. For the last 2 years, all our bad news had come from here, there, the lost battles, the draft, the orders of the commanding officer, and I thought to myself, without stopping, what can be the matter now? Okay, we'll see the explanation for this paragraph. So, usually, all kinds of bad news, the battle lost, the draft, the order of the commanding officer, were put on the town hall bulletin board. And for the past 2 years, that is, everything has been placed in the bulletin board. The school boy wondered, that is Franz, about the crowd in front of the bulletin board. As I hurried by as fast as I could go, the blacksmith watcher who was there with his apprentice reading the bulletin called after me, "Don't go so fast, bub. You'll get to your school in plenty of time." I thought he was making fun of me and reached Mr. Hamel's little garden all out of breath. We'll see the explanation. So, as he hurried, the blacksmith watcher along with his apprentice advised him not to go fast, as he will get to his school in plenty of time. Franz thought he was making fun of him and finally reached Mr. Hamel's little garden. So here, apprentice means the trainer or the watchman. Next paragraph. Usually, when school began, there was a great bustle which could be heard out in the street, the opening and closing of desks, lessons repeated in unison, very loud, with our hands over our ears to understand better, and the teacher's great ruler rapping on the table. But now, it was all so still. I had counted on the commotion to get to my desk without being seen. But of course, that day everything had to be as quiet as Sunday morning. Here, first we'll see the meaning for the hard words. Bustle. Bustle means move in an energetic manner or full of rush. Next one, unison. That is simultaneous utterance. Next one, rapping. Striking with audible blow. Okay, here we'll see the explanation now. So usually when school begins, there would be a great bustle that could be heard out in the street, the opening and closing of the desks, then lessons repeated loudly in unison, the teacher's great ruler rapping on the table. But that day the school was unusually silent. Through the window I saw my classmates already in their places, and M. Hamel walking up and down with his terrible iron ruler under his arm. I had to open the door and go in before everybody. You can imagine how I blushed and how frightened I was. But nothing happened. Mr. Hamel saw me and said very kindly, "Go to your place quickly, little Franz. We were beginning without you." We'll see the explanation now. So, through the window, Franz saw his classmates already in their places, and Mr. Hamel was walking up and down with his terrible iron ruler under his arm as usual. With a blush on his face, Franz entered the room with petition in his heart. but Mr. Hamel allowed him to enter his class in a kind way. I jumped over the bench and sat down at my desk. Not till then, when I had got a little over my fright, did I see that our teacher had on his beautiful green coat, his frilled shirt, and the little black silk cap, all embroidered, that he never wore except on inspection and prize days. Besides, the whole school seemed so strange and solemn. But the thing that surprised me most was to see, on the black benches that were always empty, the village people sitting quietly like ourselves. Old Hauser with his three concerned hat, the former mayor, the former postmaster, and several others beside. Everybody looked sad, and Hauser had brought an old primer thumbed at the edges, and he held it open on his knees with his great spectacles lying across the pages. We'll see the meanings. Solemn means formal and dignified. Next, thumbed means book often read, frequently used. Now we'll see the explanation for this paragraph. So here, Franz noticed that his teacher has worn his beautiful green coat, frilled shirt with a little black silk cap. Mr. Hamel wore this dress only on inspection and prize days. The whole school was silent. Franz then saw some great people from his village sitting quietly on the back benches. Old Hauser, the former mayor, the former postmaster, and several others besides. Everybody looked sad. Franz wondered what was happening that day. Next paragraph. While I was wondering about it all, M. Hamel mounted his chair and, in the same grave and gentle tone which he had used to me, said, "My children, this is the last lesson I shall give you. The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsek and Lorraine. The new master comes tomorrow. This is your last French lesson. I want you to be very attentive." So here we'll see the explanation for this paragraph now. Mr. Hamel, in a gentle, grave tone, informed students that day's class was the last lesson. The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsek and Lorraine. Since that was their last French lesson, he requested everyone to be attentive as the new master will come next day. What a thunderclap these words were to me. So here, without understanding the situation, Franz felt very happy. Next paragraph. Oh, the wretches, that was what they had put up at the town hall. My last French lesson. Why, I hardly knew how to write. I should never learn any more. I must stop there. Then, how sorry I was for not learning my lessons, for seeking birds' eggs or going sliding on the sar. My books that had seemed such a nuisance a while ago, so heavy to carry, my grammar and my history of the saints, were old friends now that I couldn't give up. And M. Hamel too, the idea that he was going away, that I should never see him again, made me forget all about his ruler and how cranky he was. We'll see the meanings. Wretches means in a very unhappy or unfortunate state. Next word, sar, it is the name of a river. Next one is cranky. Cranky means very strange. We'll see the explanation for this now. So, Franz felt sorry that he did not learn French. Instead, he went seeking for birds' eggs and playing truant. It was heavy to carry his books. He was sad to miss his old friends and even his French master, Mr. Hamel. Poor man, it was in honor of this last lesson that he had put on his fine Sunday clothes, and now I understood why the old men of the village were sitting there in the back of the room. It was because they were sorry too that they had not gone to school more. It was their way of thanking our master for his 40 years of faithful service and of showing their respect for the country that was theirs no more. We'll see the explanation now. The village people were sitting on the last benches because it was the last French lesson. They felt sorry for missing the school. This was to thank and show their respect for the master for his 40 years of his service in that school. While I was thinking all of this, I heard my name called. It was my turn to recite. What would I not have given to be able to say that dreadful rule for the participle all through, very louder and clear, and without one mistake. But I got mixed up on the first words and stood there, holding on to my desk, my heart beating and not daring to look up. We'll see the explanation for this. So here, while I was thinking, here I refers to that boy Franz, who while he was thinking about this, his master called out his name. So Franz was asked to recite the rule of the participles, that is the grammar part, which he was not able to answer it because he had neglected to learn. He stood up to recite but stumbled on the first words. So he was unable to answer the question which was asked by his master, French master. Okay, we'll stop with this, students. Hope you have understood this part of the lesson. The remaining part we can see it in the second video in today's lesson. Hope you have understood. Once again, you go through the lesson and give your reading. Thank you, students. May God bless you.